నమస్కారం భగవద్గీత 18 చాప్టర్ 66th శ్లోక ఇన్ దిస్ శ్లోక లార్డ్ కృష్ణ టెల్స్ అర్జున అబాండన్ ఆల్ వెరైటీస్ ఆఫ్ ధర్మాస్ అండ్ సింప్లీ సరెండర్ అండ్ టు మీ అలోన్ ఐ షల్ లిబరేట్ యూ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్ సిన్ఫుల్ రియాక్షన్స్ డు నాట్ ఫియర్ ఆస్డ్ Arjuna to engage his mind in devotion and engage his body in material duty. This is what he said in earlier chapters, earlier slokas. And he asked him not to give up Kshatriya Dharma because you are a born warrior, you are a king, your duty is to protect people. So do that duty. But do it with devotion. He taught this. This is Karma Yoga. Now in this sloka he says, you abandon all varieties of your dharmas, that is duties. Surrender to God. That is, there is no need to fulfill your duty, that is material duty. Surrender to God. So when one completely gives up his material duty and doing devotional service, because he is surrendering to God, so he does service to God, that is karma sannyas. So here we find karma yoga and karma sannyas were taught by Krishna to Arjuna. If we give up our duties, the material dharma, will it not bring sins to us? So we may get that question. Arjuna also had this question. So Krishna said, do not fear. I will relieve you from the sins and liberate you from material existence. So, to understand this concept, we need to know what is dharma. There are two kinds of dharma, material dharma and spiritual dharma. They are based on two different understandings of self. When we identify ourselves with body, it refers to bodily designations. Like each one gets a position for manager, officer or soldier and duties, the respective duties, obligations, norms, fulfilling responsibilities to parents, society and nation. They are bodily dharma because it is related to body. You are doing the service by using your body, so that the duties attached to body. Apara dharma or material dharma, for example, Brahmanas, you find the duties to teach, Kshatriyas to fight in the battlefield, protect the people. So this is bodily dharma or material dharma. So dharmas are taken as karma yoga, jnana yoga and bhakti yoga. So when bodily dharma is done, there should not be a sense of doership, should not be attachment to the deeds as one's own and of anchoring after fruits for oneself. So you are performing your karma with this in your mind. and keeping devotion in your mind. What is spiritual dharma or paradharma? Bodily dharma is aparadharma. When you identify yourself with soul, it is paradharma or spiritual dharma. So you feel everyone is God. Parents are God, friends are God, relatives are whomever you see. You feel they are God because God lives in everybody. So you engage yourself in devotional service to God. So if you leave material dharma, it is considered as sin. If you leave material dharma but taken the shelter of spiritual dharma, it is not a sin. So you are keeping devotion in your mind and doing bodily dharma by keeping the teachings of Krishna in our mind. Those who do not surrender to God, they have five depths. The depths are towards celestial gods, to the sages, to ancestors, other human beings, and other living beings. So Varnashram includes the procedures for releasing all this when we surrender to God. So it is like we pour water to the roots of the trees. When you pour or when you water the roots of the plant, then the entire plant gets benefited. The branches grow, the leaves grow, the fruits grow, the flowers grow. So doing service to God, it is complete. So it benefits everybody. So the service to God is so important and so significant because it is like watering the roots of the plant. And Lord Krishna has talked about bodily dharma in Vedas and how they can be performed with devotional service. So here we can see the example of Lakshmana, who gave up his material duty but engaged in devotional service. That is, he gave up his duty as a king but he was doing service to the Lord. So he was completely in devotional service to Lord. He surrendered himself to Lord. Prahlada also did the same. Everything was God for him. Whatever he said, it was for God. It was about God. So when you engage yourself in devotional service, you are, and you take surrender. You surrender yourself to him. You are taken care by the God. Bhakti Yoga is a twofold complement of renunciation and surrender. Surrender accomplishes destruction of obstacles. Bhakti secures the positive ideal of God realization. So in this sloka, Lord Krishna asks Arjuna to fight. Do it as God has instructed to do it. So God gives you instruction to fight. So you take it in that way and do it. Don't think it is your material duty. So you do it as devotional service. So there will not be any expectation. There will not be any confusion. So this is very much applicable to our life. We are all given some responsibility. We all play some roles in the society, in the country, in our families. So we have got some duties to do. So when you do that duty, do it as devotional service. So what is to be given up? What the renunciation is regarding giving up of the feeling of I do it. I am the only person who can do this. If I am not there, this will not take place. The work will be incomplete if I am not there. So let us not have such thoughts. That is what Lord Krishna says. Remove those thoughts. Do the duty as if the duty is given by the God. Take it as the duty given by God. God asks you to do this duty. So they were doing the devotional service. It is taken as devotional service. So in that case, there will not be any expectation. So if there is no expectation, there is no disappointment. So if somebody does not appreciate you, you will not be upset. If somebody insults you, you will not be upset. Because we are offering everything to God. You are doing it as devotional service only. So nothing will bother you because there is no expectation from that. You are not claiming doership. So this sloka helps us to lead our life very smoothly. We perform our duty and we have devotion in God and we are not affected by any result. So this takes us in the right path with peace. That is very much required.